They say everything can be replaced. They say every distance is not near. So I remember every face of every man who put me here. I've seen my light come shining from the west down to the any day now, any day now, I shall be released. They say every man needs protection. They say every man must fall. Protection somewhere inside these walls. I've seen your light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be released. Yonder stands a man in a lonely crowd, just crying out that he's not to blame. All day long I hear him hollering so loud, just crying out that he's been framed. I've seen a light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, we shall be released. Welcome to the first ever half midnight full moon. Happy you're here with me. We're going to start with a land acknowledgement to respect the people on whose land I'm standing now. I acknowledge the house from which I'm streaming to you was built on stolen land. I acknowledge the Nauset peoples, past, present, and future, and respect their deep spiritual connection to this land and water. I acknowledge the great force of will the indigenous peoples have exerted to maintain their survival. To the missing and the murdered women of indigenous communities across Turtle Island, a place we now call North America, may each of you be brought home. May each of you whose spirits have passed rest peacefully. I give thanks for the stories that keep these ancestors with us. And I stand with the Mashpee Wampanoag tribe, the people of the First Light, in their suit against the Department of the Interior, who is trying again to take away their lands. So today's Breonna Taylor's birthday. She would have been 27. And I'm almost 50. So I feel like I'm getting just old enough to really understand how much life 27 is and isn't. And I can remember being almost 27 and living in New York City and, you know, and as a woman, as a lesbian, I certainly had moments of fear in the city of being beaten up or harassed. I was, you know, catcalled and harassed on the street plenty of times. And as a politically active person, I had plenty of healthy skepticism about the police, but I never once was afraid that I would be murdered while sleeping in my bed. So tonight is a fundraiser for Breonna Taylor's GoFundMe, which is linked in the pinned comment. I think it's pinned, or it's the first comment on the thread. And they were hoping to raise $500,000, and they already have $4.5 million, which is amazing. And a lot of times when I see a GoFundMe like that, I'm like, oh, they're taken care of, and I keep moving on. But aside from the fact that their legal fees will probably cost millions of dollars, they're suing their local police department. I want them to have $50 million. I want them to have $100 million. I, there's no amount of money that compensates for what they're going through, and I am not the one to decide they have enough or not enough. So please donate to Breonna Taylor's GoFundMe if you can tonight. I know we're all giving and we're all stressed and doing what we can, but if you can, I'd appreciate it. It's been hard to think about how to talk about everything that's going on, and my mind keeps ricocheting back and forth between like the big picture of like, where is this all going? And then the human picture of the suffering and the pain and the rage right now. And the rage I have about everything that's happening. And I wish I had answers. I don't have big answers, but I do know that I, as a white woman, and white people need to step up our game, right? Because the job's not done. Like, we haven't gotten the job done. Like, I've marched, and I've written letters, and I've, read books, and I've done all those things, and you know what? The job's not done. So it's time to do more. And it's time to march more, and it's time to call our representatives more, and it's time to talk more, and it's also time to listen more. And that may seem contradictory, but it's actually not, because it's time for we white people to listen to and lift up black and brown voices more, and it's time for us to talk to other white people more about racism and white supremacy and how the legacy that starts with the founding of this country and the land and slave owners who had an idea of democracy that they applied, and freedom that they applied only to themselves, needs to be applied to everybody all the time. So this is a song that was written in June of 2015 after Dylann Roof murdered 9 people who were in prayer in a church in the hopes of starting a race war. A folk artist named Peter Mulvey wrote this song called Take Down Your Flag, and he was touring with Ani DiFranco at the time. She sang it too. It went sort of folk viral. His second verse was about one of the victims, and he ultimately invited songwriters to write their own second verse and share the song. And over 200 songwriters wrote their own second verse and shared the song on the internet. And we are almost 5 years out. It was June 17th. We're almost 5 years out from the anniversary of that murder. And I would have hoped that that incident would have spurred more change, both for racial justice and for some kind of sensible gun control in our country, but unfortunately we've only gone deeper in. We're only deeper in. We are so deep in it right now, you guys. We're deep in, and we got to work harder to see our way through. But this song is called Take Down Your Flag, and it's for everyone we've lost
down your flag to half staff. Take down your flag to half staff. Take down your flag to half staff. It's been too long waiting, no more debating. Thank you. shout, let it all out. These are the things I can do without, so come on. I'm talking to you, so come on.
Little 1980s Tears for Fears repurposed for these political times. I see people have come on, but I don't have my glasses on, so I can't see who it is, but I'm happy you're all here. And welcome to the first ever Half Midnight Full Moon. Unfortunately, it's raining here, so I can't see the full moon, although that would have presented a whole dilemma, right? Because the camera can't really pick up the full moon, and I'm not going to complain about that because my phone now does like 5,000 more things than I ever thought a phone would ever be able to do. So the fact that it can't get the moon, well, I'm just really not going to bitch about. And this is our real talk on racism and white supremacy version of Half Midnight Full Moon. And I was called a leftist imaginarium by a troll the other day on Facebook, talking about race and white supremacy, and I really loved it. I want to start a think tank, the leftist imaginarium think tank, right? But I think, you know, it really highlighted for me, I mean, part of what we have to do, like, we have these really obvious things we have to do, right? Like, we have to march, we have to call our representatives, we have to vote Trump out in the fall. We have to lift up brown and black voices, and we have to, you know, I'm saying this as a white person, we have to be talking to other white people about racism and how it pervades all of our lives and that it's our responsibility now to stop it, right? So we have these really clear things we have to do, right? But there's this bigger picture where what we have to do is make a world we've never seen before. And we have to go into the unknown. And I want that world. I want that better world. I'm pretty sure everyone on this feed right now wants that better world. And but it involves going places we haven't gone. And for white people, it involves giving up power and, you know, changing our world. And we have to find the unknown together because the way things have been and the way they are now is not acceptable.
Long ago, does it stop?
Hey, everybody. Hey, we have to take the good news where we can get it, right? So I don't know if this is only on Twitter right now or if it's making it around to the other platforms and the news, but there's a gay sex worker who's outing Lindsey Graham and calling on other gay sex workers to out Lindsey Graham as gay and as someone who uses sex workers. And I don't mind that Lindsey Graham's gay, and I am fine with him being sex worker positive. I mind him supporting homophobic legislation while being closeted. So here's what I've got. If gay sex workers take down Lindsey Graham, one, that would just be so fantastic. But two, if gay sex workers take down Lindsey Graham, I think the Democratic Party needs to add, you know, sex worker unions to their party platform for this year. I mean, really, they need to do that anyway, right? But, I mean, come on. We will owe gay sex workers everywhere a huge debt of gratitude, right? Yeah, those of you who know me a little know that I have a whole sort of, like, hippie woo-woo side. I mean, I did call this show Half Midnight Full Moon, after all, right? You know, so there's that. I studied Indian religion in college, Hinduism and Buddhism, and went to India, and I studied Tibetan Buddhism in particular. And so I'm actually gonna do an astrology lens on where we are right now. And I know those of you who aren't into astrology are going to be like, oh my God. But just bear with me. Bear with me. So, we are right now, the planets are right now, for the first time since 1776, in the exact same position they were in 1776. For the first time. Takes 240 years for Pluto to orbit the sun. And for those of you who are going to say Pluto's not a planet, it is a mass which orbits the sun. Just go with it. And, you know, what happened in 1776 was that these rich, white, land-owning and some slave-owning men decided to throw off the oppressive powers of the British Empire, right? And in doing that, they came up with this philosophy of freedom and the republic. The democracy wasn't quite there, but freedom. The only problem is they only applied the freedom to themselves, right? And here we are, 240 years later, and every right that has been won for every other group besides rich white men has been hard fought for decades, if not centuries, and obviously the most fundamental struggle in our country is the struggle of black and brown people to be free here. And we are now in this moment where we are seeing the most extreme manifestation that I've ever witnessed of greed and white supremacy elevated to the highest levels of our country, and we are seeing people rise up. And I am not saying all of this to say, ooh, it's in the planets, we can all sit back and rest. No, no, I'm saying the opposite. It's in the planets. This is our moment, and we have to seize it, and we have to make everything we can make of it so that real change can happen, and we can find out what true democracy is, what real freedom is, and stop this violence. Stop this brutality, this insanity in our country that just keeps happening. We have to stop it. And so I thought that I would honor my hippie woo-woo side and end with a Sanskrit chant tonight with this. And if anyone can name what this instrument is in the chat, the first person to do so will get a free Love Never Dies t-shirt from me. Just making sure it's open on both sides. Mm-hmm. Ah, yes, it is. Good. So if you know what this is, put it in the chat and you'll get a free t-shirt. I'm going to chant Loka Samasta Suki no Bhavantu. I know, gobbledygook. If Arielle is still here, she knows what it is. Loka Samasta Suki no Bhavantu means may all beings everywhere be happy and free, and may my actions and thoughts contribute to the happiness and freedom of all beings everywhere. And Sanskrit is a phonetic language, and it was developed really believing that the way it vibrates inside you changes you, and that has been my experience. Love each other. Work for justice. Make peace. Make music. Drink water. Take deep breaths. I'll see you out on the front lines. I'll see you at the next full moon. Can't wait to see what you all do. Much love. Much peace. I'll go through the chat and say hi to you all. Take good care.